Hi everyone, it's Roseanne. I am here with my design team project for December, my first one for December for D's store, Elegant Embellishments. And this time I was inspired once again by my good friend Marlene, and she showed a video a couple of weeks back where she altered a vintage toy violin, and I was so enamored by that I had to. I mean, the very next day, I had to make one. So I got out my good old trusty chipboard and got to work. So without any further delay, here we go. This is my altered violin, and it is entirely constructed of black chipboard. This is the chin guard, and I left this one unpainted and unglittered so that you could see it's just hot glue that I used to make the edge and all the decoration here, so all around the edge, after I built the violin with chipboard, I painted it and then put these big globs of glue, hot glue, around it, and then I put glitter on top. And I painted the whole thing. I used the Martha Stewart, I think it's the gold paint. And there's a lot of imperfections there. And I was telling my friends, the Skype girls, that I thought maybe I should have made it a little bit fatter. But other than that, pretty pleased with the result and how it came out. And it's just rolled up chipboard there. And I put wire. And this is all chipboard. Just painted chipboard. And that's the back. So, starting with the back, once I constructed the whole thing in the same fashion that Marlene altered the back of hers, I think she altered the back of hers because it was scratched or damaged or something, and she wanted to conceal it with the lace, but I thought it looked so pretty that I thought, you know, I'm just going to follow her lead and do a lace collage. So what I did was I used 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of D's vintage laces, and the Roxy Berry, and also the resin heart there. And this is just a piece of junk jewelry, and then one of my vintage images from my computer. And this one is a tea-dyed lace, and so let me just go ahead. I'm going to actually turn you this way. I'll show you all the laces that I did use. So this lace is the one that I wrapped around here, and I wrapped it all the way around to the back. And this is the ruffled lace, so it goes all the way back here. And then this lace is tea dyed, and it is the braided lace. Which is this one. It comes out white, but you know, after you tea dye it, that is the beautiful result. Gorgeous. This one is the vintage lace that we all recently received in our design team packages. This beautiful cream color vintage lace is just absolutely gorgeous, and it is really large. I also used the eyelet lace, and that's in its natural color. It comes in that color, and it is right here. Gorgeous. And excuse me if I'm speaking low. Everyone is asleep right now. Okay, this one is in its original state also. And that lace, among all of them, is one of my favorites. That's this one. So gorgeous. And all I did was, you know, you just make your little flower by gathering it up. And then this little piece here is my favorite, absolute favorite of all, and that is from the gold piece here. Also vintage. Gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. And all I did really was just cut a little section right here, and that's what I used to place here. Just a little section, and then I used the resin heart, which you can see it better here in my hand. And this is, again, it's the Roxy Berry. Okay. The front, I used the brand new connector set and flower set, and this particular piece, metal piece, is from the flower metals, the metal flower set here. And that set is a 30 piece set, and that is what it looks like when it comes to you in the set. And all I did was put a bling on the inside, just a standard bling. And then this flower here was made with all four layers of her flowers, again from the 30 piece flower set. And I mean, I use so many pieces from this set, and I still have a bunch to play with. So what I did was I took the large flower, the extra large flower, then the large flower, then the medium flower here. Oh no, I'm sorry, this one, this flower. And then one of the little teeny flowers, and I just bent the pieces up. I glued them all together with the glossy accents, and I stuck a pearl in the center, and that is the result. And this, which you can't see, is part of the connector set. And let me move these over here. It is, and I love these connector sets because you can bend them and cut them and mold them to whatever you want. But I basically just cut this in half and used both of these two pieces separately to flank the flower here. So I put one here, one half here, and then the other half back there. And then I just added a flat back purl and some bling. This is just a little embellishment that I made from feathers and sequins and bling and beads. This is a piece of red pearl strand, and I just tied it in a knot. And then because this was inspired by Marlene, I had to use my last little ballerina that Marlene gave me, just as she did on her violin. I placed the ballerina there, and I think she's so gorgeous. She came out so pretty. And then all of this here is layered on top of the heart, and that is this one. It's tea dyed, and this is it's how it comes in the store. I use the tea dye version. Gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. And all I did was, you know, place the heart here, and then I just wrapped it around the edge there. So the heart, you know, now that it's buried, you still can see some of its beauty here, but my cluster happened to bury the whole thing. These little metal pieces here came to me from Go, and Go is Flame, Flame Rick here on YouTube. He's such a dear friend. And then all I did was put bling on top. And as I said, this is black chipboard. The entire see, it still lifts up. I guess I gotta glue that down. Violin was made of black chipboard, and then I just painted it. And I made my little stems here for the wire, and then wrapped it around. These are just rolled up pieces of chipboard here and here and here, just glued to the side. And I think that's it. I think that's all I can tell you about my little violin. I had the best time making this. I mean, I just absolutely love. I can't get it all on screen. The result and how it came out. And I'm so pleased that I have one now for my very own. When I saw Marlene's, I fell in love with it. Absolutely fell in love. And now I have one of my own. So that's my design team project for Dee's Elegant Embellishment Zibit Store. I will have all the I will have her channel link and her store link down in the bottom in the description, so that you can pop on over there to her store and grab some of her goodies. And I hope you like my project. Thank you for watching. As always, thank you for all your comments. Thank you to all my new subbies, all your wonderful emails. And God bless everyone. Bye, everyone. Oops, also, I forgot to tell you, before I go, Dee is always getting in new yummy goodness. She's posting them every single day. So don't forget to visit often. And she just received some new metal goodness that she is going to be adding to her store. Oh, you're not going to want to miss those. And she also has added a kit of bling that's gonna go like in the center, like rhinestone bling that we'll be able to glue inside the center of the flower kits, and even we'll be able to adorn the connector sets. So go on by very often, because she's adding new things every single day. Okay, everyone, thanks so much for your time today, and love you guys, and God bless. Bye-bye.